Welcome to the Campus Solutions 9.2 PUM Image 25 video feature overview for financial aid updates. PUM Image 25 was delivered on April 26, 2022. Along with bug fixes, PI25 includes enhancements and enterprise component features. 20 accessibility bugs are included in PUM 25. Financial aid updates for PI25. We have delivered our annual update to COD for award year 2022 to 2023 processing. As part of the common object update, we have delivered the new 5.0A schema and retired schemas 2.0 and 3.0A 3.0E. In addition, the delivered COD edit codes were updated to include the addition of edit 227 and modifications to the edit message description for edits 043, 071, and 205. For 2022 to 2023 direct loan processing, we have delivered an update to include the new direct loan attendance cost tag in the award block of the generated COD XML file. This tag is required to establish a new direct loan and is not required for maintenance records. The federal cost of attendance value will be leveraged to populate this field in the COD XML file and will be displayed on the following pages, View COD Data, and the Application Financial tab on Manage Direct Loan Application. In addition, Edit 226 has been added to the delivered COD edit code. A bug has been reported where the direct loan attendance cost value is including decimals and the schema placement is incorrect, which is resulting in direct loan awards being rejected by COD. A post-PUM Image 25 PRP will be made available to fix these reported issues. Please visit Knowledge Document IDs 2859618.1 and 2860062.1. Next slide. Effective the 2022 to 2023 award year, the payment period end date is a required tag to be included in the disbursement block of the generated COD XML file. This tag is required to establish a new direct loan and is not required for maintenance records. As a reminder, the payment period start date was previously required for direct loans. You will set the validated payment period end date for direct loans within the valid terms for career page. By default, the loan payment period end date value will be used for the validated payment period end date field. You can update the validated payment period date to another date if desired. You are required to save the page to be able to leverage the entered payment period start and end dates in the COD XML file generation. Next slide. The validated payment period end date and validated payment period start date for direct loan awards will be displayed on the following pages, View COD Data and the SULA tab on Manage Direct Loan Application. You can manually override the validated payment period start date and validated payment period end date for direct loan awards on a per-student basis on the SULA tab of the Manage Direct Loan Application page. In addition, Edit 227 has been added to the delivered COD edit codes. As indicated in the Dear Colleague letter, DL22-01, the annual student loan acknowledgement borrower completion will not be required for the 2022 to 2023 award year or beyond. The authorization and disbursement COBOL processes have been updated to no longer check for the completion of the annual student loan acknowledgement. When an individual applies for a PLUS loan on studentaid.gov, they are required to indicate their relationship to the student as part of the application. The CRSP file sent to schools will include this value. The ability to load this updated file and display the value was delivered in PUM Image 21. As part of the 2022 to 2023 Pell Grant processing updates, the payment period start date and payment period end date are required tags to be included in the disbursement block of the generated COD XML file. This tag is required to establish a new Pell Grant award and is not required for maintenance records. The pre-existing logic that determines the Pell Grant payment period end date has been updated to also determine the payment period start date. The term begin date and term end date from the SVATERM table will be used to populate the payment period start date and payment period end date for Pell Grant awards. You can override the payment period start date and payment period end date for Pell Grant Awards on a per student basis on the GEPL details page. The payment period end date and payment period start date for Pell Grant Awards will be displayed on the following pages: View COD Data and the Pell DISB tab of the Manage Pell Payment page. Edits 227 and 228 have been added to the delivered COD edit codes. Effective 2022 to 2023, the incarcerated code will no longer be used. This field will only be viewable for award years 2021 to 2022 and prior. The incarcerated student indicator has replaced the incarcerated code, and it is an optional field to be included in the disbursement block for Pell Grant Awards. You can manually set the incarcerated student indicator code on the Pell information page that is available via the Pell link on the packaging status summary page. We have updated the pre-existing incarcerated code drop-down selection to map to the new incarcerated student indicator field. The incarcerated student indicator will be displayed on the following pages: View COD Data and the Pell DISB tab of the Manage Pell Payment page. The Pell Grant Electronic Statement of Account report has been updated to include the guarantee unique identifier number. Updates have been made to allow for loading and display of this updated report file. The Pell Grant year-to-date record has been updated to include the payment period end date and incarcerated student indicator fields. Updates have been made to allow for the loading and display of this updated record file. As previously mentioned, a post-PUM image 25 PRP will be delivered to resolve the reported direct loan attendance cost bugs. We will also deliver an update to the loan underscore disbursement and Pell underscore disbursement population update records to add the payment period start date and payment period end date fields as selectable fields. Additional updates will be delivered to allow for the loading and display of the 2021 to 2022 Pell Grant Electronic Statement of Account report, as it was also updated to include the guarantee unique identifier, UEI, number, and to resolve an issue with loading the incarcerated student indicator in a Pell disbursement file. In partnership with the Financial Aid Advisory Group, we are addressing a concern with the delivered financial aid bind records. We have updated the SQL views in the bind records to eliminate additional effective dated logic for enhanced performance. We are delivering this update for financial aid bind records in stages. For information regarding which bind records were updated in PUM 24 and the records targeted for future releases, please visit Knowledge Document ID 2798878.1. We've only shown you the highlights of the financial aid updates in this PeopleSoft update image. For more information about these features and the other enhancements for all PeopleSoft products, go to the PeopleSoft information portal for updates.